Hey guys, welcome to the daily news analysis of 10th of February, guys. Let's see the very first news. First news is about India Health Fund, which is going to boost the research in tuberculosis and malaria. So basically, this India Health Fund has is an initiative which has come up by the Tata Trust in the collaboration with Global Fund. And this, they are basically coming forward to financially support the innovation and technology which is designed to combat the tuberculosis and malaria kind of diseases in India, right? And it mainly aims to support new products and strategy that impacts the entire life cycle of tuberculosis and malaria. Because up till now, you know, these sort of projects which were been going on in this field of this tuberculosis and malaria were somewhere lagging, right? So in order to fast track these things, you know, this India Health Fund is there, right? And also, guys, it will support the individuals and organization who has already been, you know, associated with this kind of initiatives. Means it's not fruitful, na, for this India Health Fund to fund those projects from the scratch, right? So it will basically fund those projects which has already been carrying out, right? And we just need the financial support. So it will fund those projects, and it will be much easier, and also it will be much sustainable and scalable solution, because there will be, you know, less fund that will be devolved on those kind of projects, right? So that's why this is the initiative. Next news is about Kailas Yatra, which is going to take place via Nathula, and it is going to resume. Actually, before a few days, we have already discussed about the Doklam issue. The Doklam issue was regarding the capture of China in this region. So that time China has blocked this Mansarovar Yatra that was taking from this Nathula Pass, right? So recently China has reconfirmed that they are going to restart this Kailas Mansarovar Yatra through Nathula Pass. And this Yatra is organized by the government of both the sides, that is government of India in cooperation with government of People Republic of China, right? And remember, they are People Republic of China, right? And if you just telling that Republic of China, then that will be Taiwan, right? So yeah, just try to like see the wording difference, right? The annual pilgrimage holds a religious importance for Hindus, Jains as well as Buddhists. And guys, the major Indian partner that are the, you know, that are organizing these yatras are state governments of Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Delhi and Indo-Tibetan Border Force, as well as Kumaon Mandal Vikas Nigam Limited, right? These all things you don't need to remember though. But anyways, since it is Mansarovar Yatra, so let's see about here. This is the location of Lake Mansarovar, which is present in Tibet, right? And guys, Mansarovar Lake is located at an altitude of around 15,000 feet, and it is said to be the highest freshwater lake in the whole world, right? Next news about Competition Commission of India. Actually, it was in news because they have recently slapped a fine of ₹136 crore on Google for the unfair business practices that they are carrying out in Indian market. In fact, I have observed it myself also, because earlier whenever I used to purchase anything, and you know, I just used to search it out, then the answer for Flipkart was coming at the top list, right? But now always I see that Amazon products are coming at the top list. Now why this? Because, you know, Amazon is a company of United States, so right, and they might have given money to Google to showcase their product at a very top list, right? So that's why, you know, Google is, you know, showcasing their product in top list, in spite of the fact that product, the cost of that product in Flipkart is much cheaper than the Amazon, right? And this I've personally observed, guys, right? So yeah. So anyways, guys, we'll read here about Competition Commission of India. What is it? So it is basically a body which is responsible for enforcing the Competition Act 2002 throughout the India. And it also prevents the activities that have an adverse effect on the competition in India, guys. It eliminates the practices having adverse effect on competition, promote and sustain competition, as well as protect the interest of the consumer, which is the main thing. Because as I've already given you the example, say for example, since the Google is showing Amazon at a very top list, so I'll be first seeing the clicking the Amazon product, right? If they would have shown me the Flipkart product, then I might have purchased that product, because that product was much cheaper, right? So I mean, they are just changing the, you know, choice of consumers, right? And it also ensures freedom of trade and market of India. And guys, about this Competition of Commission of India, guys, remember, this is a statutory body which was being formed by this Competition Act of 2002. So guys, next news is about separate flag for Karnataka. Actually, before few days, Karnataka government has set up a committee, and they have set up a committee in order to get the recommendations about the separate flag that they wanted for their state, right? So the result of that committee has came up, and that committee has said that yes, there's no problem, because if you see the constitution provision also, then there is no provision in the constitution for which the state to have its own flag. Means the constitution doesn't prohibit the state to have their own flag. However, the manner in which the state flag is hosted should not dishonor the national flag. Say, for example, in Karnataka Legislative Assembly, they are, you know, setting up their state flag in this height, right? So they must have ensured that if they are setting the flag of national flag, then the height of the national flag, our tricolor, must be, you know, at the top of this state flag, right? So that will be the honoring of our, you know, tricolor, right? So this is about it. And guys, the proposed state flag will be tricolor, that is a yellow, white and red with state's emblem at the center. And the state government will now seek an amendment to enable provision of including the Karnataka flag. Basically, the state government is going to pass an amendment, if and that amendment is accepted by the center, if the center gives this no to it, which actually center will give, I guess. So Karnataka will become then the second state after Jammu Kashmir to have its own flag in India, right? Next news about RBI, guys. Actually, Reserve Bank of India is going to link the base rate with MCLR, that is marginal cost of fund based lending rate. And basically, they have proposed to link this base rate of loans with the marginal cost of funding rate, just because of the reason that after coming up this MCLR, many banks have not accepted it, right? So that's why RBI thinking, let's link this to, then there will be no confusion. Actually, what the thing, the purpose with which this marginal cost of fund based lending rate came up in India was to improve the monetary policy transmission, right? So in order to improve the monetary policy transmission, main aim was to, you know, this bring with this MCLR, just because of the reason that in earlier base rate system, what used to happen was, say for example, 10% is the base rate, right? So what is base rate? They give, say for example, they are giving a home loan, right? So they are giving home loan for 2% plus base rate, means the home loan will be given for 12%, right? If you know what I mean. If they are, you know, giving the loans for motorbike, then they will say that okay, we are keeping it for 1%, means actually the motorbike will be given on 11% interest rate, right? So this is the, you know, interest criteria of, I mean, the earlier interest criteria. But after coming of this MCLR, that is marginal cost of fund-based lending rate, it was to ensure basically that the monetary policy transmission, which could not have happened with this base rate, because base rate earlier was, you know, introduced at a very huge interval of time, but MCLR has a provision of introducing itself at a very, you know, shorter span of time, right? On a monthly basis, in fact, right? Under which it was very much easier for banks through the MCLR provision, that MCLR provision was little bit much lesser. I mean, the rates were much lesser as compared to the base rate, right? So since the banks, every banks were not including this, replacing their base rate from this new MCLR, that's why RBI have thought of linking these two base rates with MCLR, right? So just remember it, because it's already popped up in your prelims paper in the year 2016, I guess. Yeah. Next is about SpaceX Falcon Heavy, guys. Actually, what is it, guys? It is the world's most powerful rocket. It is said to be the world's most powerful rocket because, you know, it has the ability to lift into the orbit nearly 64 metric ton of a load, right? And recently, guys, it has been launched in order to, you know, send it an orbit near the Mars. And it is said that it is for the first time that a car is also being sent into the space. And if this Tesla Roadster will survive, then, I mean, it's 500-hour journey that will be carried out through this Van Allen belt, which is a region of high radiation, right? So it will be said that if this survives this Van Allen belt, then it will have an attempt, a final burn towards Mars, right? And remember, guys, this Van Allen belt in itself is a very important term for, you know, prelims perspective, because they might directly ask that among the four of the option, I mean, they might give that what is Van Allen belt. They might direct ask you, right? So just remember this, Van Allen Belt. Next is about the committee. Actually, you just have to remember the name of the committee, that is Vinayashil Oberoi Committee. Actually, the Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has constituted a 13-member body, which will be, you know, headed by this Vinayashil Oberoi, right? And mainly this committee is set up in order to monitor and expedite the capital acquisition project for the modernization of armed force, right? So what it will do, guys, it will basically suggest the measures to improve the capital acquisition process, and it will undertake an independent review and review and check the status of ongoing critical projects which is worth more than ₹500 crore. Next news is about Tawang Rhododendron Park, guys. Actually, first I'll show you what is rhododendron, because you'll find it in your geography books also, right? So in a bid to conserve the dwindling rhododendron species, which was being taking place in the Tawang region of Arunachal Pradesh, so the government have thought of mainly coming up with this rhododendron park, which will have modern nursery, informative center, as well as resting sheds, for this rhododendron species. And it is said that over 330 species of rhododendron will be planted and conserved across the park. About the rhododendron, if you'll see, guys, then they are found in varied habitats, from subtropical forest to alpine shrubs, right? And they are mainly found in cold moist slopes and deep valleys of eastern Himalayas, right? And this is because they are mainly found there because it provides a conducive environment for their growth, right? So that's why this was the news. Next news is about a report which is called Healthy States Progressive India Report. This report has been come up with Niti Aayog, because Niti Aayog has released it. It is written here today, but it was actually yesterday, right? Because this was taken from the PIB news, right? So yeah. So basically, Niti Aayog has released this comprehensive health report, which is titled as Healthy States and Progressive India Report. It ranks various states and union territories on the innovations that they have brought about for year-on-year incremental change in health outcomes, as well as their overall performance with respect to other states, right? It is the first attempt to establish an annual systematic tool to measure and understand the heterogeneity and complexity of the nation's performance in health, right? And since, guys, it ranks different states and union territories, then you can set it to be their tool of leveraging the cooperative and competitive federalism. Because since it states rank, so every states will think that, okay, I want my rank to, you know, see higher in this merit list, right? So that's why it will act as a sort of, you know, competitive federalism, which will accelerate the pace of achieving health outcomes for them, right? Next news about Hunar Haat, guys. Actually, this we have discussed many a times, but anyways, it is organized by Ministry of Minority Affairs, and it is being mainly launched so that the minority section of the people who have some sort of their artistic and craftsmanship knowledge, so they come up in a platform which is being provided by the government, right? And it will basically provide a market and opportunity for the talent of master artisans and craftsmen from across the nation. And through this, the aim of the government is to ensure that this Make in India, Stand Up India, and Startup India initiatives pops up at a very high rate. And pops up in the sense what? They are continued at a very high rate, just because of the reason that if this artisans and craftsmen are being given this national platform, then of course it is, you know, promoting Make in India's initiative, hana? And since they are, you know, entrepreneurs in themselves, right, so it is also promoting this Stand Up and Startup India initiatives, right? So that's why Hunar Haat supplements these kind of initiative of the government, right? So that's why this was in news, guys. And yeah, it was over, guys. And about economic survey, if you haven't seen, the Hindi part of it is already available. I'm giving you the link below. You just go through it. I have already completed 5 chapters, right? So just the thing is that everything are given in Hindi. So if you are at all comfortable in Hindi, you can watch it, right? And regarding the mains answer writing, guys, I've already done the mains answer writing in English as well as Hindi, right? So if you at all have not seen it, I'll just give the link of that also in my, you know, description of this video, so you can go through it, right? And trust me, those are very effective, because those are going to enhance your knowledge yourself, right? And regarding the Telegram channel, guys, yeah,
regarding the Telegram channel, so by this name I have a Telegram channel in which I upload the PDF materials, right? So I'll be uploading the PDF material of February month, that is first week and second week of February together, right? So you can access that, right? So yeah, this was all about the today's news, guys. We'll meet in tomorrow's class. Till then, bye bye, take care, and thank you for listening to this video, guys. Thank you very much.